bare. And what she has to say is once again provocative and even controversial. Here's Chris Cuomo.
When Annie Lennox sings, it's as though she is at last letting down her guard and revealing her secrets.
And this is how I feel. Do you know how I feel?
Searing emotional pain.
I've been bought and I've been sold. And love is rock and love is roll.
Or a love letter.
Every day I write the list of reasons why I still believe they do exist.
Or a fleeting moment of pure joy.
But I feel wonderful.
People may know your music, but do people know Annie Lennox?
Well, they don't need to, really.
You know, you have a reputation for having very revealing music.
Yes, I think that's revealing enough, no?
For this most private of public figures, perhaps the only window into her soul has been her music. And the picture is often one of loneliness and heartache.
Does it mean if it's coming from you that you're sad, that you felt the emotions that are in the song?
Absolutely. I couldn't sing about them. I wouldn't write about these things if I didn't experience them. I'd have no knowledge of them. I probably would be writing the happy, happy stuff, wouldn't I?
Do you ever want to write the happy, happy? Do you ever find yourself saying,
I write what I write, you know. I mean, you know, if I wanted to be a professional songwriter, I'd be writing for Celine Dion, wouldn't I?
And at 48, Lennox has begun to reveal herself in a new way. Through the lens of a camera in a startling series of self-portraits. What we see is a woman coming to terms with age. In a society that has made the quest for youth something of an obsession.
So I thought, do I make myself try to compete with this youth market culture that I'm in? Or do I kind of go the opposite way and show, expose my fragility, expose the fact that my skin is older?
It's an almost unthinkable degree of honesty. But that's perhaps why so many women are drawn to her music. So many seem to identify with her struggles.
Why do you think that women identify with you and your music so strongly?
Look, we have a long way to go to evolve beyond where we're at, and that we need to empower ourselves. But in doing so, we threaten men. And there's a bit of a difficulty there. Venus and Mars, it's tricky.
From the very beginning, almost 25 years ago, Annie Lennox aspired to more than just making music. She wanted to make waves.
Don't mess with a missionary man.
With her band, The Eurythmics, Lennox challenged our perceptions about gender, beauty, and power, selling more than 30 million records along the way.
Essentially, I wanted to make a fresh statement. To be perceived as something kind of radical and different and empowered. It did make people react, it made people discuss.
The emergence of the Eurythmics seemed perfectly timed, coinciding as it did with the arrival of another cultural phenomenon.
I want my MTV.
Suddenly, music was a visual medium. Lennox and guitarist Dave Stewart saw an opportunity.
Dave and I felt that the videos were a fascinating extension of the music. It was like another way to interpret what we were doing. We were both like kids in a sweet shop.
Guitarist and collaborator Dave Stewart concentrated on the Eurythmics' signature sound. Lennox provided the style and passion. The result? Songs now considered classics.
Here Comes the Rain Again, because it comes here frequently in England. It's a theme of our lives. And then, what do you write after that? So another line came, falling, because rain falls, falling on my head like a memory.
Memory, like a memory. Falling on my
Though Lennox had become an icon by the late 80s, she and Stewart decided on an amicable breakup of the band. Lennox began what would be a successful solo career.
Money can't buy it, baby, baby.
But eventually, she chose to stop writing about life and actually start living it.
People say, well, what were you doing in the last 8 years or so? Well, I didn't really know what I'd been doing. I was living my life, taking care of my kids, you know, just meeting the day's requirements, really.
For most of the 90s, Lennox was a virtual recluse, very privately struggling through personal hardships. Twice married and twice divorced, she's now the single mother of two school-age daughters. And she continues a lifelong battle with depression, where her most effective therapy may be her music.
Come to me, run to me, do well me, down with me, cold, cold.
So if you decide, okay, you know, I'm not so happy, two options. Go and do something constructive with it, or go and drink a bottle of whiskey. What's it to be?
And then, after 10 years, Lennox got back to a place in her life where she could again get back to writing and into the studio.
My children are a little bit older. They can deal with me not being there 24/7. So the question came to my mind, you know, well, I think I'd like to try to write another song. That's how it starts. It's something that you feel within you that needs to be expressed.
Today, Lennox is a pop diva, but gone are the chameleon-like appearances and the rock star trappings. The singer, once known for her wild looks, has stripped away her many masks to reveal everything. That's why she called her new album, Bare.
I never want to close my eyes again. Never close my eyes.
Never gonna close my eyes.
I'm 48, which in a lot of women's terms is not particularly young. It's also not really very ancient either, but if you look at solo female performers, most of them are in their early 20s, are sort of half my age, you know. And curiously now, I feel very much like a solo artist and very much in my prime. To accept the process of age like everybody, and if I can still make my music and be of some value, then that's a fantastic thing to do. And if by doing so I may be opening some doors for some other people to come through, then, you know, all the better.
Is it
Sweet dreams still for Annie Lennox. Her new CD, Bare, entered Billboard at the number 4 spot. And we'll be right back.